The decision that I have to make in this case is not an easy one, but it also bears in mind the great impact that this particular case has had on the community as a whole. And I have to send a message of deterrence to people that reckless driving, drunken driving, homicides will not be tolerated by our court system. There are new laws in place recently that were enacted considering reckless driving. And those laws aren't made by me, but they're laws that I have to consider. And what I have to look at here in this court today is what is the penalty that I need to give to Mr. Silva in order to recognize the worth of the life of Aaron Strong, to punish you, Mr. Silva, and you will come out of prison. There, that is a guarantee. You are a very young man at age 23. But in order to deter you from further acts of criminality, in order to send a message to the community that this behavior is not acceptable and that it impacts all of us here in the Milwaukee community, in our state, and in our court community as well, the sentence of the court is going to be as follows. As to count one, homicide by intoxicated use of a motor vehicle with a prohibited alcohol concentration, the sentence of the court will be 18 years. The initial term of confinement in this case will be 12 years, followed up by 6 years on extended supervision. Mr. Silva, the time that you are confined in prison can be extended if you violate any prison regulation or if you refuse or neglect to perform any required or assigned duties. If your time in prison is extended under this bad time provision, you could be required to serve up to the total length of your sentence. The penalties that can be imposed by the Department of Corrections are 10 days for the first offense, 20 days for the second offense, and 40 days for the third and each subsequent offense. In addition, if you are placed in adjustment, program, or controlled segregation status, your term of confinement can be extended by a number of days equal to 50% of the number of days that you spend in adjustment, program, or controlled segregation status. Finally, if while you are in prison, you file a lawsuit, which the court finds to be filed for a malicious purpose or solely to harass the party against whom it is filed, or if you testify falsely or otherwise knowingly offer false evidence or provide false information to the court in that lawsuit, the court can order that your term of confinement be extended up to the total length of your sentence.